So ladies and gentlemen, today I'm bringing you guys a video on what is going to have to be one of the easiest high round strategies that you can do on the latest zombie map revelations. So I'm going to be taking you through guns, perks, specialists, anything that you really need to get to high rounds the easiest possible way without going down. By using this strategy, you have a high chance of actually not going down, because personally I've used this strategy about 2 to 3 times and I've got to about round 70 plus without going down. The only way I could die or go down by using this strategy is by my game crashing. So this strategy is pretty easy to get your head around, but we're gonna get straight into it, so let's do this. Alright, so starting off with the strategy itself, it's located in the starting room. Now you don't really have to open or close any doors for this to be successful. I had both doors open throughout the gameplay and it was perfectly fine. You just kind of got to use some perfect weapons for this strategy. So getting straight into weapons, what do you want to have for your high round game? What are the best weapons that may give you that extra push to maybe not let you go down? So the primary weapon you're going to be using the most will have to be the Apothecan Servant. Now you can upgrade this, you can have it unupgraded, doesn't matter. It really doesn't matter with the power of the weapon, it kind of just matters how long it actually lasts. So I do suggest you using the upgraded Apothecan Servant, as it does have a little bit more ammo in there, but the Apothecan Servant is a must have with this strategy. For secondary weapon, you probably want a Thunder Gun, just to get out of sticky situations when you are cornered or if you are in just a little bit of a pickle and there's something going on. Just use your Thunder Gun, it's gonna get you out of there as quick and as easy as possible. And the Thunder Gun does have a little bit more ammo than the Apothecan Servant, so the Thunder Gun is also very good, but the Apothecan Servant is a little bit more efficient. I also suggest taking a third weapon in for your high rounds game, as you will be getting a lot of insta kills, and the Apothecan Servant and the Thunder Gun aren't really insta kill weapons, as the damage is just too high, so what's the point of wasting your ammo? So a gun I do suggest just for insta kill, you can get this out of the box, or you can actually wall buy this weapon. This is the M1927. It's the Tommy gun from Mob of the Dead being brought back in to Revelations. I take this out on every high rounds journey just so I can actually use it when I do have an insta kill, because it's very good and it just slaughters the zombies when you are using this weapon with insta kill. Now, moving on to pack a punch abilities, we have various options of abilities that we could choose from. We can go from Deadwire to Blast Furnace to Turn to Fireworks or even Thunderwall. But one I like to use the most will have to be Blast Furnace, as it does the most damage. Now you may be thinking that Deadwire is most efficient. Yes, it is, but I'd just rather Blast Furnace, because you're not using your Tommy gun a lot. You're mainly using your two wonder weapons that you have, but if you do have Mule Kick, you're gonna grab this Tommy gun. You probably want to get Blast Furnace on it, as it also does give you your Widow's Wine back. But if you don't know what Widow's Wine is, just stick around, I'm gonna explain it later. But if you do use Blast Furnace, you do have a high chance of getting those little icons back, which means you have a high chance of actually not going down. Okay, so with weapons being out of the way, we're going to be moving on to perks. Now, perks are a main thing we need just to get through the game and get to the highest round possible. Now, personally, I didn't buy any perks throughout this game. I actually used a Perkaholic. Now, this is a gobble gum I actually do suggest. Perkaholics, they are a lifesaver. They give you perks whenever you just buy the gobble gum. You get all the perks on the map. And what else could you ask for? Because this gobble gum is so overpowered. And with me not going down the whole game until my game crashed, it has made it a whole lot better. That means I have 3 quick revives in reserve instead of having 2. And I don't have to worry about saving up for points. So Perkaholic is a must. But if you do not have a Perkaholic and you're kind of new to zombies, what I suggest is Juggernaut, Stamina Up, Quick Revive, and Widow's Wine. Not Double Tap, because we're not really caring about damage, as the Apothecan Servant has like infinite damage, and the Thunder Gun, you're not really using that as much as the Apothecan Servant, and your insta-kill weapon isn't going to be affected with Double Tap at high rounds. So those are the perks I do suggest. Moving on to Gobblegums, I'm not going to give you a 5 Gobblegum list, because half of them aren't really for high rounds, but previously I did suggest Perkaholic. But another Gobblegum I do suggest, especially at high rounds, will have to be Alchemical Antithesis. I always take this on every map I play, because this Gobblegum, all it does, once it's being activated, it gives you all your ammo back and much more. It's seriously an overpowered gobblegum, and it is a must-have for high rounds. When you do pop this gobblegum, it actually does speed up the rounds a bit because you're just wasting all this ammo because you're getting it all back anyway, so it doesn't really matter how much ammo you're wasting. But when you use this gobblegum, oh my god, this thing with the upgraded apothecary servant and even the thunder gun is just so overpowered. It is a must-have, and to unlock this gobblegum, you actually have to go through the ranks. This is the last gobblegum you unlock on your first or second prestige, it doesn't matter. But if you are going to prestige, I do suggest permanently unlocking this gobblegum. So going on like specialists and extras, what I suggest is actually having the DG4s out of the box. This is the specialist from Dorizendrak being put into Revelations, and the only way you can get these bad boys is from actually hitting up the box. Now they're pretty easy to get. I get them by about round one, round two, it doesn't matter what round I get this weapon out. I get them and it's actually accidental. So these are really handy, especially when you do have insta-kill. But for like monkey bombs wise, I do suggest getting little Arnie's and maybe upgrading them. Only upgrade them because it does do a little bit more damage when upgraded, and they do last a little bit longer. Little Arnie's work the same way as monkey bombs in previous games, but seriously, little Arnie's are so underrated, and you do need these just if you get in sticky situations and maybe don't have a little bit of ammo left, and maybe if you just pop in that alchemical antithesis and you don't have any bullets left in your weapon, just use the little Arnie's and it's gonna give you some points and some kills. And lastly, with the strategy itself, all you gotta do is stay in the first room and go around the pillars and just kind of go up to where the ritual site is. It's pretty easy, and a fun fact about the ritual site is that zombies don't come in from teleporters, so you can pretty much camp up there if you want, but personally I like to train, so I'll just train around the middle. And this isn't the fastest strategy in the world, but it's possibly one of the most easiest. I don't like camping as much as training, because training is just more efficient and it gives you a little bit excitement to the game and gives you a little bit more nostalgia whilst playing. So pretty much repeat the strategy, you're gonna get to round 50 60 70 80, it doesn't matter what round you're gonna get to, you're gonna get there, and it's gonna be quite easy. So hopefully you enjoyed this little bit of an easy high round strategy guide. If you did, be sure to smash a like on it, shows you guys really support the video. Subscribe to the channel if you are new to stay up to date with all my zombies content, because I do a lot of strategy guides like these when new maps come out, and I like to get to high rounds, so stick around for that. Comment down in the comment section below if this strategy was successful, and I'm gonna be seeing you in the next video, guys. Peace out and goodbye.